Hello दोस्तों, welcome to the channel of PCPIP. I welcome you all in this series of lectures. Today we are going to discuss two concepts. Very first is connection oriented service versus connection less service. So directly we are jumping to the differences between these two services, and we'll discuss later on the simple diagram with the example. Now let's take here we have the slides. Where we have three columns. Very first column is what the parameters. Very second column is what the connection oriented service. And third column is what connection less service. So before dealing with the differences between these two services, let's first analyze what is the purpose of these two services. And these services are going to be used for transferring the packets from the source to the destination with the help of these two mechanisms. So in this mechanism, what kind of stuff need to be done? That need to be understood over here. Very first parameter, I can say this is the setup. Now setup is required in terms of the connection oriented service. Okay, before sending any data over the network, we require to set up the fixed path, that is virtual path I can say, which have a number. Whereas the connection less service, the setup is not required. The second difference will be of phases. There are three phases in the connection oriented service. Very first phase is setup phase. Second would be data transfer phase. And after the successful data transmission, there would be tear down phase. But in the connection less services, there will be a direct data transfer. There are no such kind of three phases are available. The third will be splitting of packets. There will be no splitting of packet done at the connection oriented. Whatever the size of messages are there, as it is, those messages are going to be passed from source to destination. But whereas in a connection less service, the message is broken into smaller unit known as packet. So this is very important term, that is message is broken into the small unit known as packets. Then route. In connection oriented service, packets follow the same route. There is no any choice. There is no any freedom to transfer the packets from the source to destination in between. Random one. No, whatever the path is selected, first of all, at the first phase, those path only will be selected for the data transmission or packet transmission. But in a connection less service, the packet do not follow the same route. They have full freedom to travel from any route. Let's say if I have a router R1, R2, R3. Initially, it was the path R1, R2, R3. But in case of the connection less service, router R1, R2, R4, R5, anything can be possible. Next would be on the basis of feasibility. Connection oriented service is feasible, but the connection less service is not feasible. The second would, next would be processing, data processing and transmission at the source only. So whenever there is a requirement of data transmission after the setup phase, so data processing is done. Process is done, transmitted at the source only. But in terms of the connection less, data is processed and transmit not only at the source, but at the each switching stations. We can say in between the routers, whatever the routers are connected in that only, that also it is going to be processed. Dependency of the packets. So there is a dependency among all the packets. In connection oriented service, the dependency is full of, let's say if I have a message having the phone numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. The order, if the whatever the order the sender have sent, only those order need to be followed every in between station. But in terms of the connection less service, there will be no dependency among the packets. It's complete freedom. So packet 1 can travel from route 1, packet 2 can travel from route 2, packet 3 can travel from any route N. So this is what the dependency. Congestion. In connection oriented service, congestion is not possible. That is less congestion. Because there is a dedicated path available, and dedicated path is full of bandwidth, so there will be no congestion occurring in this particular. Because the channel is also not shared, But in terms of the connection less service, the connection less service congestion is possible because more than one packet can choose the same route. So that time the next congestion can be possible. But it is although it is very faster service. The connection less service is very faster one, guys. Another is what the example, connection-oriented service is related with the telephone system. Whatever the telephone system what we have in our home, That is the best example of connection-oriented service, where the fixed path of that telephone line is fixed at beginning, and then only we can use for the data transfer or calling and etc. But whereas in terms of the connectionless service is related to the postal system. It is going to be changed randomly. It is going to be changed dynamically. Then would be a channel. Channel is dedicated in connection-oriented service. The one who you are the owner of the channel is going to be used that channel, dedicated one. But a connectionless service is a shared channel. Channel can be shared among the multiple packets wanted to be transferred from source to destination or in between also. And this is preferred for connection-oriented service is preferred by long and steady communication. As like a telephone line fixed path, it is going to be preferred by long communication and steady communication purpose. But in terms of the connectionless service is preferred by the bursty communication, where there is a full of packets are available, like internet nowadays. The internet is using connectionless service with the help of UDP protocol. Speed high, it is a very speed is high because due to a dedicated path in the connection oriented service. Connectionless service is as compared to the speed will be low, but it is going to be if the freedom is there. So speed in that terms also it is going to be high. So guarantee of packet delivery. The guarantee of packet delivery, yes. But in terms of connectionless, does not guarantee. Reliability is obvious. Connection-oriented service is reliable. Connectionless service is not reliable. Bandwidth. Connection-oriented service required a bandwidth of high range, whereas connectionless service required bandwidth of low range. Setup cost. Setup cost is more in terms of connection-oriented. In terms of connectionless, it is going to be very less. Sequencing of the packets. Yes, that sequencing of the order packets need to be followed. But in terms of the connectionless, it is not going to be followed. Apart from this, there is a total delay. Total delay will be more. A total delay in terms of setup cost, data transport cost, and the teardown phase. So these are the three phases are there. So in that term, setup delay is more. And total delay is more. But in the connectionless, there will be very less setup delay. Resource allocation. Resource allocation required prior to data transfer in the connection-oriented, whereas in connectionless, it is not required. Packet loss. If link or router fails in connection-oriented service, if the links or router fails, there will be no alternative path. So if the alternative path is not there, the packet is going to be lost anyhow. But in terms of connection-less, the packet get lost. Only if the packet get lost, that time only packet get lost. If packet get corrupted, that time only is possible. Alternative path. There is no alternative path available in connection-oriented. But in terms of connection-less, there will be alternative paths are available. Implementation. Here we can implement it flow control, error control, congestion control. But in terms of the connectionless service, here we cannot implement flow control, error control, and congestion control. The best protocols are available with the connection oriented, like TCP, HTTP. More than that, and again connectionless, like we can say IP, UDP, ICMP. These are the protocols are using this connection oriented and connectionless services. And last point, what we can say the use for. So the connection-oriented service is used for the reliable message thing, for example, sequencing of pages, reliable bytes thing, for example, song download, unreliable connection, example, VoIP, Voice over Internet Protocol. In terms of the connection-less, the datagram with the acknowledgement, that is text message with delivery reports. And next would be request reply, for example, queries from remote databases. So these are the plenty of differences what we have discussed so far. Now just go to the jump to the diagram where these things are going to happen. Now this is what the slide we are showing the working of this model, that is connection oriented service model. This diagram is also adapted. So if you consider this sender and if you consider this receiver, in between this what we have the different routers R1, R3, R4, R2 and something. Okay, so whatever the message need to be sent by the sender, so first of all, before sending the message, they need to send a setup request. So there are two auxiliary flags. Out of two auxiliary flags, very first is the packet request, setup request. As a request to the setup, the receiver will give the reply, that is as an in terms of the acknowledgement. So after that, only the path is going to be set from sender to R1, R1 to R3, R3 to R4, and then R4 to receiver. Then receiver send one label as acknowledgement, then I am ready. I am ready to receive your messages. Then after sending the receiver, receiver sends to the R4, R4 sent to the R3, R3 sent to the R1, and then to the sender. In this case, we have done with the setup phase. After that only, the data transfer is going to happen with the help of the routing table, where the label, the source address, the destination address, and actual data is present. Every node exchange their labels, because every path having the labels. On the basis of that labels, the packets are going to be transferred. There is a fixed path. And after that, the connection is going to be teared down. In this second diagram, we can see the total delay. Here, setup time is required, delay, because source need to be sent the message to the receiver. Receiver replies, okay, I'm ready. Then only data transfer is done. So data transfer from source to intermediate node, required, time required. Then intermediate 1 to intermediate 2, time required. And to the destination. Then after that data transfer, it is going to be tear down phase. So these all three delays are what the total delay I can see. So this service is what a kind of a telephone service where these three phases are required. It takes too much time. The second one, connectionless, where there is a diagram shows that source to destination, again, the packets 1, 2, 3, 4 are having a full of freedom. Let's say packet arrives at the R1, R1 having a three routes, R1 to R2, R1 to R5, R1 to R3. The packet number 3 has chosen the R1 to R5. Packet number R1 chooses the R1 to R5. Then 1 and 2 have the path is, let's say, R1 to R3. After reaching to the R3, R3 is having another two routes. It can go from the R3 to R5. The 2 is passing in this direction. From this R3 to R4, the 2-1 is passing in the direction. So there are multiple routes are available. And after that, here, every packets are received, but there is no sequence. You can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the sequence. This was the sequence, but in the receiver end, there is no sequence, exact sequence. The receiver can receive in any order. Okay. And after that, the reassembly or the assembly is going to be happened at the receiver end. So this is what a kind of mechanism connectionless, where it is very faster service. Nowadays in internet, this all the services are going to be used. That is specifically this a connection less service is going to be used very more, and connection oriented is what in particularly in telephone system. Okay, thank you guys, thank you so much. We'll meet.